We've all heard of unwanted people getting access to our cloud computing networks, virtual machines, and other assets. One of the critical and foundational ways to protect against this are network security groups on Azure. You can use an Azure Network Security Group to filter network traffic to and from Azure resources in an Azure virtual network. All right, let me show you what I mean. Imagine you have a standard Azure virtual network that contains three subnets that are all receiving traffic from the general internet. It is common practice to not just let anything access the networks. Not only do attackers frequently scan IP addresses for openings, but who wants to expose everything on their networks? To protect our Azure virtual network and devices, we can use NSGs in different ways. You can chain NSGs together. In the case of VM1, NSG1 is attached to subnet1 and evaluates all traffic from the internet to that subnet. NSG2 is attached to VM1 and only evaluates the traffic allowed through by NSG1. For VM2, there is only NSG1 as the VM doesn't have a network security group attached specifically. VM3 in subnet 2 has NSG2 associated with it, but the subnet doesn't have any. And finally, VM4 is left unprotected, at least when it comes to NSGs. All traffic will reach VM4. In short, NSGs protects networks and VMs in Azure from unwanted internet traffic, either by being associated with a subnet, a virtual machine, or both. So how do network security groups then protect resources? Rules. Lots of rules. Rules that come for free. Rules you have to configure. Rules to keep you warm at night. Well, almost. Let me give you an example of a rule. Priority 1000, name MongoDB, port 27017, protocol any, source 127.0.0.1, destination any, and action allow. Now this rule is most likely attached to a VM that runs MongoDB. It specifies which port is allowed to be used, 27017, and that only IP 127.0.0.1 can access that port. If traffic matches this rule, it is triggered and the NSG processing stops. Rules are made up of eight properties. Name, this is whatever name you like. Not like Paul or Susan, but more descriptive of what you're doing with the rule, like allow RDP. Priority, this is a number between 100 and 4096, because bits and bytes. The lower the number, the more important the rule. In other words, a rule with priority 150 is processed before a rule with priority 200. Once a rule is triggered, the processing stops. Source, this is an IP address, a block of IP addresses, everything called any, a service tag such as storage or Azure Active Directory. Source ports, a single port or a range of ports. Destination, that's the same as the source in terms of how you've set it up. Destination ports, that's also the same as the source ports. And protocol, TCP, UDP, ICMP, ESP, or any. Cheese wheel, that would be delicious, but no, there isn't one. And action, this is either allow or deny. Now rules are processed one after the other according to priority, and when one matches the traffic, the processing stops. You can create as many rules as you want, up to 1,000, but it can quickly get overwhelming. Using groupings such as Azure service tags, blocks of IP addresses, and ranges of ports can help manage it much better. At this point, you might wonder how Azure NSGs are different from Azure firewalls and when you should use each. Simply put, NSGs are meant for filtering traffic within a single virtual network, whereas firewalls protect networks across applications, networks, and even subscriptions. Use NSGs for VNets and individual VMs. Use firewalls for large infrastructure applications and projects. Okay, let me show you how to create an NSG in the Azure portal and set up a couple of rules.
While you can set up a network security group on its own, the most common way to do it is actually by creating a virtual machine. So I'm going to do that now and just show you how that works. So if I have the virtual machines here, I'll add a new virtual machine, like so. And then that opens up the wizard for creating virtual machines in the portal. I've already created a resource group called Fundamentals. because that's what we're looking at for NSG. We'll give the virtual machine a name, like so. And we will just leave everything as default. I'm not going to change anything, because this is not a fundamentals episode in creating a virtual machine. We're creating a network security group. Disks are fine. The networking here is that we have a new virtual network, NSG VNet, that's fine. We have a subnet, we have a public IP, and then we have a NIC network security group, which is where it creates a network security group while creating a virtual machine, because you normally have one attached to a virtual machine. So we'll leave it as a basic, that's fine. And we're going to allow SSH publicly. I'm aware that this is not what you would do normally, but just to have some rules that we can look at. The management, we're going to leave the management as is. The advanced tab is about extensions, user data, that's all fine. We're just going to go straight to review and create. And then we click create. Make sure you download private keys if they are created, because otherwise you will never be able to retrieve them again. And now everything is being deployed. So let's look at the resource group that we just created everything inside. And we can now see that there are a number of things that have been created, one of them being a network security group. So let's have a look at that. In here you can see there's a number of rules that have been created already. So the rules are down here, inbound and outbound security rules. You can see here that the SSH access on port 22 has any source and any destination allow, which means anyone can access this particular virtual machine with the SSH key pair that we downloaded earlier. Now, if I wanted to add a rule, I can go on the left here to inbound security rules. As an example, I can add a rule and I can choose the source, IP addresses, service tag. So if you wanted to, for example, have a service tag of Azure Load Balancer or Virtual Network or Azure Monitor, any of these can then access this particular device that this network security group is protecting. And you just put in your port ranges, your destination, the service, as an example, could be one of these or a custom. So if you choose some one of these services, it will automatically set the port for you, such as if we set FTP, you can see the port is automatically set for that and the protocol. And then we have an action, allow or deny, and they give it a priority. So 310 will be after 300, which is the SSH rule. And we can add that. So it is that simple to add rules. You can also do this in PowerShell, or the CLI, or ARM templates. But it is a very good idea to have a standard around these rules, how you generate them and create them, and what they protect against for your particular company or project. It can get really messy really fast, and then you don't know which rule is being triggered when. That's network security groups for you. There's custom rules, there are default rules, and go forth and secure.
There you have it. Network security groups. They keep your VNets and VMs secure and warm at night. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for everything cloud computing. So with that, keep being awesome, cloud gurus. Skip to the demo, blah, 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 blah. Rules.